Hello everyone, I'm Hassan Yimmer from Integrated BIM. Today I will be going through your struggles you have been facing when you move from one phase to another, for instance from conceptual design to schematic, from schematic to detailed design, and when you do changes in Revit. And I will be also covering how to resolve those changes. Most probably the frustration comes from either you have been using an improper template, or you have been not planning ahead in the project, or you didn't do some of the simple basics that today we are going to cover, or else you don't watch the integrated BIM videos. When I say that, I mean it, because any videos we publish is solely to improve your BIM skills. Therefore, please don't forget to like and share this with your colleagues. Also, subscribe to this channel in order not to miss any of the great content. Let's build a modern house together. And we should start with setting up the project. And let's jump into it. I encourage you to do a couple of steps before you move forward with Revit modeling. So the first thing you need to do is you need to come to the Manage and check your project information. That's a very important part of the whole process, because you need to input the right amount of information at the beginning of the project, so that contains the same information throughout the entire project lifecycle. And a couple of other things to do is a survey point, position, coordinates, and location. And let's look at them very quickly. The coordinates will have two coordinate points. One is the project base point, and the other is survey point. So this is the two points where one is the surveyor, where he puts the machine, the machinery, where he takes the information from, and the other, the origin point, where he takes the first information out of that building or site. So the next thing you need to do is you need to arrange your true north. The reason for arranging it, if you do it later, well, you might face a lot of issues, a lot of constraint issues or problems with the project. You might lose some dimensions and so forth. So it's always suggested to do it at the beginning of the project. Therefore, set it up right away. So make sure that your view is set to the true north, and then you can change your true north depending on the angle you are looking for. You can also pick a point if you, or pick a line if required. The next thing is, if you are taking the surveyor's data, obviously you will be placing your survey point and project base point to that false location from the surveyor's information. You can also acquire coordinates if there's a Revit model or any other file format that can be acquired data from. And the location is also a very important part of the process. So if you are doing analysis, take the right data set from the right location. The next point is to tackle the datum elements before we move forward. So let's get back to the project north and let's go to level one. And let's make sure that we have a proper grid set of our site boundary. If you don't have a site, you can also do a like basic grid set of 2 meters or 4 feet of distance, depending on 5 feet of distance, depending on your unit and location. But let's, in my case, I have an imperial setup, so I will be doing every 5 feet a grid. I can also use easily an array by clicking, selecting the grid and using an array. Make sure that the first number of the grid is 1, because it will be repeating its data of like from 1 onwards. So if I click array, and if I do the second, and I select the space from the first to the second, and I say 5 feet, and I click 5, and then I select how many numbers I want. If I select, for example, 8, I'll have 8 grids. I can always ungroup them if I want to by selecting all of them and ungrouping, or I can just select and move one of them. So coming back to the grid, and I will do one horizontal. So I will just repeat the data coming from this side towards that direction. And I will go with A, and I will repeat that grid for, again, 5 feet, and I will have about 12 of them. Once we have the grid set up, we can use them as a reference point, and we can constrain some data to the grids. So the columns, the walls can constrain to the grids. Next thing, what we need to do is, very important, is the levels. We need to set the levels at the beginning of the project, not towards the end. So what I'm going to do here is I will be selecting the level 2, and I will be doing a couple of more levels by going on the create similar CS. You can also type CS on your keyboard and write 10 feet. And I will have 2 more levels at a 10 feet distance from each other. So I will have 1 and 1 more. So what I will do now is I will just select and group them all and drag one of them higher and then drag this towards this direction and take this to the left. So now I have my datum elements set up, I have my project information set up and basic information, all of them are set up. Now I can move on the next part and decide on the LOD. By the way, if you would like to learn more about the LOD, you can click on the pop-up link above and we will have a 10-minute video where it explains everything you need to know about the LOD. So the next thing after your decision on the LOD, which will be also depending on your project phase. I'm at the moment in the conceptual phase of the project. I need to design an idea. I can use conceptual massing or basic walls. Once I'm at the location, I don't care about so much detail, so much information. I'm more interested in the visual part of it and basic quantification, so I can get an idea on the project estimate as well as the time frame of the project depending on its design and complexity. So next thing what we are going to focus on after we decide the LOD is also the topography. We did not include the topography. We don't know in this case what is the site because we don't have survey data, but I will just assume that the site is just flat, very flat. So I will be using without a topography. And if I put a topography, I will just put 000 as a border of the site. So which has just a flat site, a plane. But if you have a survey data, I encourage you to put it in. And if you don't have, and if you want to get a quite accurate site information, you can also click on the pop-up link above. We also made a tutorial by using CADMapper and you can get a very accurate site. I wouldn't say as accurate as a surveyor or real life scenario, but it's quite accurate. Then you manually do it on your own, like with a manual survey, I would say, by just going on site and measuring a couple of areas and doing it yourself. That is really a great tool and it's for free. That's the great part of it. So let's come back to the level one. The next thing you need to focus on is the location line. And that's really important. And a lot of people, trust me, avoids that thing. So I have to click on the walls and choose one of the walls that I'm going to use. As I said, I'm not focusing on the details. So I need to choose a wall that is more or less what I'm looking for. In this case, my wall is 1 feet, 7.5 inches. Obviously, if I'm looking for somewhere between 1 feet, 8 inches or 1 feet, 6 inches, I can probably use this wall at this point of the design because I'm not 100% sure whether I'm going to go with a brick finish or whether I'm going to use concrete masonry, maybe I use in-situ concrete or any other particular design or construction. So depending on what I'm going to find, it will change. Perhaps I should find something close by so when I change, the design doesn't alter so much. One of the most important part over here is the core boundary. Look at the core boundary. I have it, the internal finish, the metal furring and the gypsum. I have the external finish, I have the damping, insulation, and the brick and some air. So this is really important because I am going to take core boundary layer, external finish as my location line. What do I mean by that? If I create a wall and I select this core boundary finish face exterior, and if I start drawing my wall this direction, look at what happens. If I go into fine details, I will have my insulation, air, and my brick on the exterior side and my finish on the interior side. You can also see by looking at this icon if it's showing this way. I mean, whatever area it's going to show, it indicates that it's exterior. So if it's this way, its exterior is facing that direction. If it is facing this direction to the right, the exterior is there. And the important part of this one, because most of the time, most of the countries, not every country, but most of the countries, they are taking the distance from the boundary of the site to the structural component. So they don't include the finishes. If this is the case, in the future, if I have a side boundary here, I want to make sure that my offset is, let's say, from the side boundary, I will be randomly saying about 8 feet, right? So if I have 8 feet from the side boundary, or let's say 10 feet, just to round up, I want to make sure that my structural part is 10 feet. In the future, if I decide to change my construction of the wall, meaning I don't want that much air, that much insulation, or I don't want the brick, so, but let's say the insulation and air is, I want less. So maybe the insulation is 4 and the air is 0.5 inches. And then look at what happens. My structural item, now I don't know why this dimension moved for no reason. So if I get it again from the finish, if I click OK and OK, you can see that my core boundary does not change. I just picked a wrong location. Well, today we focus on basics. and how to get started with your modern project. You can also apply with any type of projects these things. So in the next part of the tutorial, we will be discussing on how to build the walls and some system families properly, and then we will be building our project when we go along. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, because we will be publishing a lot of content for you. And when you comment, like, and share any videos in our channel, it greatly supports us and encourages us to make more videos for you. Therefore, your support is highly appreciated. Thank you, and see you next time.